Hi. So you've got a little monster won't do a thing you tell him, who seems to be in a world of his own, or his little quirks seem a bit eccentric. A couple of people have dropped things like ASD or Asperger's into the conversation, and you're starting to wonder if there's any weight to it. Or maybe you've just got back from the doctor who's referred you to a specialist. Now you're checking out the internet to get the lowdown, and it's scaring the living daylights out of you, and you're thinking, this is confusing me. So, in this program, Lorraine Sharp, who's been through this scenario not once, but twice, shares some of her experiences, advice, and possible solutions. We'll try to break it down a little, with separate sections on pre-diagnosis and diagnosis, symptoms and effects, sensory issues, triggers and anticipation, visual aids and social stories, medications and diet, special interests and obsessions, and finally, outside help. What you do have to remember though, is that it's not all doom and gloom, that there will be magic moments as there is with every child, and although the conditions are not curable, there's often still light at the end of the tunnel.
ASD, which stands for Autism Spectrum Disorders, is an umbrella term for a number of conditions that include a triad of impairments which are consistent throughout the spectrum. Otherwise, virtually no two diagnoses are the same.
What is it like to have an ASD?
I don't know, because I don't have an ASD. But one of the things that brought it home to me, what it was like to have an ASD, was the scenario put to us at one of the courses I attended. So, imagine if you will, a group of strangers who are told they're going to play a game to get to know each other. The game is to pack a suitcase for a holiday. The first person is asked one item they'd like to take, and everyone in the group is asked in turn. The first person says sunglasses, and they're told, yes, you can take sunglasses. Next person, sun cream, and they're told, no, you can't take sun cream. And so it goes on. Wine, yes. Swimming costume, no. Toothpaste, yes. So it's coming around to your turn, and you're worried about what you're going to say, because there doesn't seem to be any logical explanation as to why you get a yes or a no. So as your turn gets even closer, you become uncomfortable and anxious. Your heart rate increases, and you might get sweaty palms or knots in your stomach, because you really want to get a yes, you want to get it right. By the time the person next to you is answering, you just want to run out of the room, because you still have no idea what the rules of the game are. The rules of this particular game were you got a yes if your legs were crossed, but of course you didn't know that at the time. The point of the game is to let you experience the anxiety levels and ASD experiences in an everyday situation. That gives you a clue as to what it might be like. In this programme, I'll be going through some tried and tested strategies and methods to help your child, and explaining some of the difficulties with diagnosis and why it can take so long. Although I'm not a doctor, I'll outline some tips and tricks that have worked for me. However, the carers of classical autism cases might not benefit as much from these. So come back soon for the next episode, which will cover pre-diagnosis and diagnosis.